In this lesson, I will explain to you the concept of utility-based agents in artificial intelligence. I will try my best to make it as easy as possible, but here I will highly recommend if you didn't watch my previous videos, which are related to simple reflex agents, model-based, goal-based, I highly recommend please watch this video because today's topic is utilities-based agents. It will be much more clear to you if you know the background. Especially model-based agent you have to watch. So here I'm going to explain you that this is the utility agent. Our focus will be on utility, not the goal state. So model-based, which we learned so far, is divided simply, you can say, in goal-based or utility-based. Or in other words, we can say that goal-based agents and utility-based agents are the extensions or expansions of model-based agents. Means they both have the properties of the model-based agents plus their own properties. Here we have to focus on goal, but in here we have to focus on utility. Even though we have to reach to our goal state, but focus will be on utility or utility function. What is utility? I will explain to you in this lesson. Another important point is that goal-based and utility-based both work on partially observable environment. What is the meaning of partially observable environment? Means the agents do not have full information about the environment. I will give you the very simple example here. Suppose if you are going from one place to another, suppose you are going from Toronto to Montreal, you know the route. Right, you know the routes, but you do not know how many cars you will see in the when you will go from Toronto to Montreal, how many trucks will be on the road, how many bikes will be there. So it is called the partially observable environment, means we do not have complete information about the environment. Okay, and one more thing related to utility agents, that utility agents work if we have or if the agents have multiple routes or multiple possibilities to reach the goal state. If there is a single opportunity, then we cannot apply utility agent because it works on the multiple different routes or multiple different options. So here the same example, first I will explain to you utility agents with the help of example, then I will read what I have written for you in my next slide. Suppose here you are going from Toronto to Montreal, right? So we assume that it will take 4 hours to reach from Toronto to Montreal. Just the example. In 4 hours, suppose we will take 3 stops. First of all, we will give our destination to GPS, and GPS will provide us 2 or 3 different routes how we can go from Toronto to Montreal, and definitely we will try our best to follow the shortest route. Okay, we start our journey, and the first, after 1 hour, we will stop, right? This is our first stop, and in first stop, we are discussing utility. Right, our focus is on utility. Whatever function we will perform, we have to check on each state, each stop here, that whether we are or agent is happy or unhappy. In utility, we will see the happiness, happy or unhappy. First stop, okay, agent is happy. We reach very smoothly according to our time. So in first stop, we are happy. After 1 hour, we did our second stop. Again, we will check, right, the utility function. Happy or unhappy? We reached according to our time. It means everything was fine. Road was smooth. No problem. So it is happy. Third stop, right? Unfortunately, the road is blocked. Maybe the construction is going on, or maybe some accident, or whatever the problem is there. So in the third stop, the agent is unhappy because here we have some obstacles. Now what we have to do? We will change our route, because utility agents works if we have multiple options. We will change our route, right, and we'll take another route to reach Montreal. So when we will go to the third different route, again the state will be happy and finally we will reach to our goal state. But here we have to follow the utility function, happy or unhappy, right? Even though we have to reach to our goal state, but we have to focus here. So same thing, whatever I had explained here, I have written here. If you will see the things I have written with red, it means these are important. These kind of questions can come in your MCQs. These agents are similar to the goal-based agent. I already explained this because this is the goal-based and utility-based is the extensions of model-based, but provide an extra component of the utility measurement, which makes them different by providing a measure of success at a given state. What is the meaning of measure of success at a given state? Just take the previous example. In first stop, we were happy because everything was fine. We were going smoothly. So measure of success means it was fine. Second stop, our measure of success was happy, fine. Third stop was unhappy. Then what we did, we changed the route. So in every given state, we have to check the measure of success. Utility-based agent act based not only on goals, but also the best way to achieve the goal. Means here I said we have to take the shortest route to reach Montreal. Utility-based agent is useful when there are multiple possible alternatives. See, if we have a single, we cannot apply utility. Multiple. Because if in any state we are unhappy, we can change. We can change to another route. The utility function maps each state to a real number to check how efficiently each function achieves the goal. Right? So if the questions come like this, which agent, in which agents, multiple possible alternatives are required. So you have to say utility based. Right? So these points, red points, can come in your MCQs. Here I will explain to you with the help of example. This is our environment. With the we sense or we assume or we percept here that we have to go to Montreal. What the world is like now? What is the current situation? Current situation is we want to go from Toronto to Montreal, but here we are not going to take immediate action. Immediate action we take only in simple reflex agent. Keep in mind, we apply if and else condition, right? But here we do not take conditions. So come here, any action. How the world evolves. How the world evolves means history or the our knowledge, past experience. We will see how previously we went from Toronto to Montreal. So here we have to use our knowledge as well. So these things and these points are same whatever we had discussed in model based. So here instead of goal based, which we had discussed in our last lesson, it is utility based. So here we have to check how happy I will be in such a state. Just like in first stop, we were happy. If we are happy, what action should I do? We have to continue our journey. Second stop, check. In each state, we have to check. Happy, continue the journey. Third stop, unhappy. So we will change the route. What action should I do now, right? And with the help of actuators, we do our actions. And then finally, we again, we are in the environment, right? So this is the simple concept of utility-based agents. Here we have to, our main focus should be on utility, not goal, right? So I hope the concept is clear. Please do subscribe my channel and thanks for watching.